Yes, so we're playing the all blue flash or instant deck that did really well at Los Angeles Magic Fest. We just wanted to try it out. It's a deck that, you know, we haven't played any mono blue decks, like aggressive decks, in a while. And this seems pretty cool, you know, differ. The base of the deck is to try and play everything on their turn. You have a lot of draw spells, a lot of counter spells, and a lot of flash creatures. Everything can be played on their turn except for Spire Golem and the lands. But everything else can be played on their turn. So you got accumulated knowledge and think twice to get through to sort through your draws. You have counter spells of 4 exclude, 4 counter spells, 4 forest spikes, and 2 condescends. So while you're applying pressure, making sure that they have to, they can't cast their spells. A tempo play other than Vapor Snag, they're playing Repulse. So they, again, you're just trying not to get stuck on Lamb Comps. Everything, most of the other cards at least draw you a card. Then for your threats, you're playing 2 Sentinels, which are 2/3 flyers with flash, 4 Pestermites, 4 Spellspire Sprites, and then 4 Spire or 2 Spire Golems. So again, it allows you to play all on their turn except for Spire Golem, which hopefully majority of the time you're casting it for like 1 or 2 mana. Then we got 3 Lonely Sandbars to make it so that, again, you don't want to get giant land comps, and so you can cycle through it. 4 Quicksands, which are good for aggressive decks on the floor, as well as it's really good against Tylish Tribe. Radiant Fountain, which is a pretty solid, like, gain 2 life. Sometimes you're losing the race, and this could change it. Then in the sideboard, we have 2 Null for either Boggles or Affinity. 1 Curfew, which is good against Gurmag Angler decks. It's also could be used against Affinity as well. 3 Dispels for decks with counter. 4 Hydro Blast for any Reg-based deck. Boomerang for a catch-all, just answer. 3 Gutshots for other Delver or Fairy decks, as well as could be used against Elves. And then 1 Fairy Macabre for Graveyard Hate. I wish that there was more Graveyard Hate in this deck, but it seems fine. Overall, though, like, it seems like a very fun deck, and I'm excited to play it. And I'll see you guys in Match 1. Welcome to Match 1, guys. We're playing Flash Blue. We'll keep... Pass turn. Or spike that. Play land. Pass turn. This one will just regular counter spell. Okay. Play Quicksand. Pass turn. This does not seem like a very good matchup, though, to be honest. We probably should have mulliganed. We drew too many more lands after that. Okay, that's pretty cool. I like that. Think twice will allow us to hopefully draw out of what we're dealing with currently, you know? We want Spire Golem. Spire Golems will probably be pretty good. Sure. Okay, and then we'll go get use thing twice. That's actually not bad. That will help us with the Squadron Hawks. Play land. Pass turn. We will take two. That is fine. Play this while he's tapped out. Well, he's not tapped out, but he only has one mana, so we can force spike whatever he tries to play. Condescend's pretty good. Pass turn. Just play a spell spur sprite on that. Seems fine. And yeah, we'll force spike that. Then think twice. Play land. We'll offer up the trade. It's not a huge deal. If well, we can't let him build too much of a board presence either, which kind of sucks. Sure. That's fine. Yep. Cycle. Okay. Pass turn. Condescend. Make him pay two more. Bottom top. Yep. That's a thing. Play land. Think we could win a race? Oh, this is starting to feel terrible. Shit. I guess so. Maybe it was a mistake to let the second one resolve. All right, exclude and condescend. They're super far ahead on the field though, which kind of sucks. Kill this guy. We go block, 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 take five, I guess. Yeah, even if we countered it, he could flash it back and still kill everything. Yeah, that's just shitty. Right, so we want. What do we want? The question. Probably gut shots are fine. Take out four spikes. Bring in a Hydro Blast. Alright, well, you just gotta be more aggressive and try to tempo him out. This is the way to go. Yes, I'd like to play first. Mulligan. Kind of slow, but probably put down bottom. Play. Land. Last turn. Try to get some bigger creatures. There we go. Play that. Pass turn. Sure. On end step, we'll repulse that guy. Or we'll just repulse him now. Alright, come on, land. That's what we want. Land. Not a land. Yep. I don't think we can race that card, so. Alright, missing out on all the lands right now. There we go. That's some more land. Okay. That's interesting. That's pretty good, actually. Play a Spire Golem real quick. Wait, we could have just kept up cards plus also have quicksand. I'm retarded. I'm so dumb. Played that entirely wrong. Well, we'll take the 5. Come on, repulse. Vestermite's pretty good. Vestermite tapping his creature. Yep. Spells for a sprite. Pass turn. Esther might tap this guy. We'll take two. Sure. Think twice. Shit. Pass turn. Yeah, that I don't want to give up this land. I don't want to give up this creature. Putting us down to 5 kind of scares me, to be honest. Both putting us down to 5 and losing the land makes me even more afraid. I should have kept the gut shot. Condescend this now. I'm putting lands on top, by the way. Hopefully we find Radiant Fountain. That would be really good. Top. Top. We gotta apply pressure. V trades with 2 of them, he trades with 2 of them, you know? Bell Screech is a thing. That is a thing as well. And this is gonna hurt. No, we gotta keep as many blockers up as possible at this point. And also, we can think twice to try to get more lands. If he has the Rally the Peasants, we're dead anyways, but we might as well block four, you know? Because he can just play it and flash it back. And that would be five damage total. Yep. That's game. That sucks.